Okay, everyone. So now we are learning the structured exception handling. Here we are learning the array out of bound. Now, first of all, to understand that we are dragging and dropping one label, let us suppose that we are taking an array which can store three elements. So let us suppose that we are taking the first element. So we are writing here first element. And afterward, for the first element, we are dragging and dropping one text box in front of that. Then similarly, we are dragging and dropping, this is second element and this one is the third element. So here in the label 2, we are changing the text, which is the second element. Then afterward in label 3, we are just changing the text, that is third element. Now afterward, in front of that, we are just dragging and dropping the text boxes. For label 2, it is the text box 2. And for label 3, it is the text box 3. Now, afterward, we are taking one button here. We are extending the size of this. Now, afterward, we are just changing the size of button also. So, here we are going to say, let's say, click. Now, afterward, we are clicking back. So, here is the click. Now, we want to change the name of form also. So, we are clicking there. Then, afterward, let's suppose that we are providing our name, which is Ankit Verma. So, we are writing here. Now, if you want to align these all labels, then we click over there on the first, then with the control we are pressing. Then we are going on the format, then afterward we are going on the vertical spacing, then make equal. So, spacing is equal. Now, according to that, we can align these text boxes if you want. So, we can align all. Now, afterward, we want to take these elements into the array. So, first of all, we are double clicking over there. Now we want that these three elements should be the part of any array. So we are going here and going to declare the array. So we know that dim ar, ar is for the array. If we are providing two, it can store three elements in the .NET as zero index, one index and the two index as string. So here we have created the array inside the button coding and this can store the three elements. Now we are going to define one more variable, dim I as integer. So one variable we have taken for running the loop, that is I. Let us suppose that we are going to assign these elements which are given by the user. The user is giving text box 1, 2 and 3 elements in these text boxes. So we are simply writing here array index 0. We are providing, that is from text box 1.text. Afterward, array first position we are providing text box 2.text. Now afterward, array at second position, we are providing text box 3.text. So this is how we have provided all the three elements which are given by the user, text box 1, 2 and 3 into array 0, 1 and 2. So now the array is full. We know that if the array is 2, so three elements can be taken, 0, 1 and 2. Now afterward, we are going to assign, let us say that we are going to apply a for loop for I equal to 0 to 4. We know that this is out of the bounds. You know that array can start from 0 and go till 2 because we have assigned till 2. Now here we are saying 4. That is a problem. Now we can provide the step if you want, or step is by default 1. Now afterward, let us suppose that we are writing a message box. In the message box, we are simply displaying the array element. So ARI. Now we are going to see that how it is working. If I just simply run this project, then afterward I am going to initialize, let's say the elements, let's say 23. We can provide the string values also because we have taken the string array. Now you know that these are the three text boxes where we have assigned some values and I will click over there. Now afterward, what is going to happen, you can see that whenever I click over there, this coding run, AR2 is declared. Then afterward, now I is declared, AR0, 1 and 2 will be taking the values from here. Now 23 is 0th place, okay. Now 45, second element at first place, okay. Now 56 at second place, okay. Now afterward, you can see that when I click, it is going back to the code. Why? Because we are going to access third and fourth index, which is not available. because you can see that AR2, it can take 0, 1 and 2, but 3 and 4 it cannot take because it is index out of range exception. It is going out of range. Third and fourth are not the part of indexes. So here is showing the error. Now this is the exception. We should handle this exception using the structured exception handling. We should know that whenever we are using the try catch block, that is called structured exception handling, and whenever we are using any other method, that is called the unstructured exception handling. So we are solving this with the help of structured exception handling. Now we are going to stop this project. Now we are going back on the coding. We know that problem can arise in this area because while initialization there was no problem. Now this is the problematic area when we are running the loop from 0 to 4. So here exception can encounter. So first of all, we are writing the try here. Now whenever I simply write the try and press enter, we can see that this is the complete syntax available. Now we should understand what is the syntax available here. Now try, in this area we are going to write the things on which we want to apply the check. Afterward, catch ex as exception. So automatically exception will be taken, and here we are going to provide what you want to perform. So try, it is just like try ball. I'm giving you the try ball and I'm checking. So here in this particular area, I'm going to provide the code on which I want to check. So I'm just taking it here and putting it here. So try, this area is going to check by the .NET now for the exception. So this is going to check with the try. So if the exception encounter in this block, then the catch block will run. In the catch block, let's say we want to say message box. So we want to provide a message box here. In the bracket, we want to say, you should understand that here is the object available ex. Whenever exception encounter in this code, now exception ex object is created. Now this ex is having so much powers. So we can provide ex dot. Multiple things are there. What do you want to provide from this ex? Let us suppose that we want to say ex dot message. Means you want to provide certain message from this ex. So you can simply take out there. Now afterward close it. Now if you want to provide your own message, you are free to do it. Let us suppose that I want to say in the message box error. You want to provide by yourself. Now error, you can say that you are trying to access the outside boundary, or you can say that array out of range. That is totally up to you. So you can say that array out of range, or you can simply say that you are trying to access the element which is outside the array. Totally up to you, whatever you want to provide. Now afterward this try catch block is over. Now we are going to run this code for, first of all, this thing. So we are going here, we're initializing some elements. Now let us say these elements are available. You understand that if I click on this button, now these three text boxes values are taken by AR0, 1 and 2, and this is the array which is having 0 to 2, these three values can take. I is the variable for running the loop. Try block is a block which is going to check for the exception. So for I equal to 0, right now the value of I is 0, so 0th value 56 is displayed, no problem. Click OK. Afterward, the first index, it is incremented to I, the first index which is 67 value is displayed. Now going on the second index, I is 2 because I is incrementing by step 1. Now 78 is displayed. Afterward when I click, I will be incremented and going to access the next element. And we know that the next element is out of range because we are having I3. The value of I is 3 and you can see that array is only till 2 and this is not available. So in that case, it is going to call the catch block. It is now not coming to coding. I have shown you earlier the program was going to the code, but it was a bad thing. So here it is now on the code. So ex exception is caught. Now the message is showing es.message, that is index was outside the bounds of array. That is the message by the .NET, by this ex object. Now click afterward OK. Error out of range. This is your manual. Manual means you have passed a message. So this is by your message. So it is totally up to you. You want the .NET message or your own message, or you want the both. Totally up to you. Then you click on OK. Now, this is how the exception was caught. If you are running the normal program, let's say you are only going till 2. We know that you are going from 0 and going till 2. In that case, exception will not come. You already know that. Let us suppose I provide certain values, 56, now 78. Now after 98, we can provide the string values if you want, because the string type array is there, totally up to you. Now click, so first 56, then afterward 78, then afterward 98, afterward okay. No exception is caught because it is perfect, our code is perfect. So 0 to 2, the try block check that, there is no problem, so catch block will not work. So this block will not work if the code is proper. But if you are going to temper the code, let's say if you are going to change it and it is going to be on exception, let's say 3. We know that 3 is out of range. Now in that case, if I again run it, now I'm providing 67, then 89, then afterward 98, and then press click. Now afterward, you can see that the first index. If I again repeat this, you know that these values are going inside this array. Now 0, 1 and 2, add these indexes, these values are taken. So 0th index is first running and try is checking. Now the second, now afterward third. So these all elements 1, 2, 3 at the indexes 0, 1 and 2 are successful run. Now is the time of third index. So click over there, third index, which is out of range. So here exception is now going to the catch block. EX is the object of the exception which was taken. Now the first message shown by the catch block is ex.message, that is index was outside the bounds of array. Now again click OK, you can see that error out of range. So this is how we can use this try catch block, and understand that whenever we are going to take the try catch block, this is the structured exception handling, because .NET is giving you this try catch block. That's why it is called structured. And if you are using any other method like go to or maybe your own code for handling the exception, that is called unstructured. So that is how we can take the exception of array out of bounds using the structured exception handling.